let's look at this illustration in capital allowance. This is the second phase of our lectures. We have finished the analysis. So we want to use this illustration to put more meaning to what we are discussing. And the question says, S Limited purchased the following fixed assets. Plant is 200,000 in 2002. Motor vehicle is 450,000 and it was purchased in 2003. They will have equipment 300,000 in 2004. And we are told that the plant was sold in 2004. Remember that the plant was purchased in 2002. Now it was sold in 2004. And whenever an asset is sold, I told you something about a balancing charge or a balancing allowance, depending on the written down value as at the date the asset was sold. Now, we have the following rates of allowances. We have the details, initial allowance and annual allowance for all the assets purchased. These rates of allowances may be given in the question or not. These rates of allowances. The tax laws have all these rates, and you should know them, at least have them in your mind, should, in case you did not see them in a question paper, you can be able to make use of your mind, the one you set up in your mind. So since the rate of allowances is given, we are going to use it to solve the question. The question said, compute capital allowance for 2002, 2003, 2004, and 2005, that is for 4 years. The first thing we are going to do now is to calculate all the values we need in solving this question. We're going to calculate initial allowance for plant, then calculate the annual allowance for plant, then we'll do it for motor vehicle and do it for equipment before we now go into the main account or the main solution. So let's try to carry out some analysis of what we are seeing in this question. At least I've given you formulas on how we can calculate initial allowance and how we can calculate the annual allowance. So let's try to carry out these calculations so that we can just go to the table and insert our figures and get the answers to what we need. Now, we're going to calculate the initial allowance for plant. Plant is 15%. That's the first thing to do. So we have plant initial allowance. I'll have the rate of 15%. So initial allowance for plant is going to be 15% of the cost of the asset, which is 15% that will multiply the cost of the asset. The plant was purchased for 200,000. So we're going to multiply 15% by 200,000. So we have times 200,000. When we do this from calculator, 15% is 0.15 multiplied by 200,000. So 0.15 times 200,000. That will give us 30,000. So we have initial allowance of 30,000. That is that. Then we're going to calculate the annual allowance of the same plant, which I've given you the formula to. The annual allowance is going to be, let's check the rate. Annual allowance is 20%. So we'll do 20%. We're going to do, the formula I gave you is C minus IA. Whatever we have here, we multiply the rate of annual allowance. So we shall be having the cost, which is 200,000 for plant, minus initial allowance. Initial allowance is 30,000. So we'll do minus 30,000. This should be times the rate of annual allowance, which is 20%. So that means we'll be having 200,000 minus 30,000 will give us 170,000. 170,000 times 30%, that will give us, from calculator, we'll have to check again. 170,000 multiplied by 0.3. We're having 51,000. So that is the annual allowance for plants. 51,000. So that is all for plants. We have calculated all the items we needed to resolve issues relating to plant. We're going to do it for motor vehicle, we're going to do it for equipment. So now let's calculate initial allowance for motor vehicles. Motor vehicles, initial allowance. The rate we have here is initial allowance is 10% and annual allowance is 15% for motor vehicle. So let us calculate the initial allowance for motor vehicle. The rate is 10%. So we're going to have initial allowance IA to be cost multiplied by rate of initial allowance. That's what I gave you. And the cost is, the cost of motor vehicle here is 450,000. 450,000. Make sure you have this question, you copied it and try to follow the solution. That's the best way you can understand what we are solving. You don't just look at the video and just be looking at it as if you are watching a movie. You have to be up and doing the calculations with me. At least your calculator will be in your hands. Now, our motor vehicle is 450,000. And so we have 450,000 multiplied by 10%. And 10% of 450,000 will give us 45,000. That is the initial allowance. Then we'll calculate the annual allowance. Annual allowance is C minus initial allowance. Whatever we have here, we'll multiply by the rate of annual allowance. So our C, which is the cost, is 450,000. 450,000 minus initial allowance we have here is 45,000. Then whatever we have here should be multiplied by the rate of annual allowance, which is equal to 15%. So this will run down to 45,000 minus 450,000 minus 45,000 is going to give us 405,000. 405,000. Then multiply by 15% from the calculator. Let's see what you have. So we have 405,000, 405,000 times 0.15, and that will give us 60,750, 6,075, and then zero. So this is the annual allowance for motor vehicles. We're going to do the same thing we did here to plant. Before we now go into the solution properly, once we get these figures done, the solution becomes very easy, because this is the main thing, using the formulas to get the initial allowances and the annual allowances. So now let's talk about plant. So I have plant, initial allowance. Let's check the rate. No, what we're supposed to talk about is equipment. Sorry, equipment. We're talking about equipment, not plant. Equipment. So the initial allowance for equipment, IA, let's check the rate. Equipment is 20% initial allowance and the annual allowance is 25%. So let's do that. Initial allowance is 20%. So initial allowance should be equal to costs multiplied by the rate of initial allowance. And that will be giving us, let's check for the cost. The cost of equipment in this question is 300,000. So we're going to multiply them out. So after 300,000, multiplied by 20%, and when we do this, we shall be having initial allowance of 60,000. Then let's talk about annual allowance. AA, annual allowance, and I gave you a formula, C minus IA, which is initial allowance, multiplied by the rate of annual allowance, RA. So we'll be having the cost is 300,000 already, minus the initial allowance of 60,000. Whatever we have here will be multiplied by the rate of annual allowance, which is 25%, as given in the question. So we'll be having 240,000 times 25%. So let's see what the calculator can do for us. We have 240,000 times 0.25, and that will give us 60,000. So we have 60,000 for annual allowance. So at this point, we have finished all the analysis. We have completed all the things we needed in calculating the capital allowance. We're going to go to the table properly to put in the figures. Now we have the table, computation of capital allowance, years, details, plants, motor vehicle equipment. Then the last column here is the capital allowance. Remember the question said we should compute this for 2002, 2003, 2004, and 2005. So we'll start with 2002. We have it here, 2002. So you talk about costs. You start with costs. Just watch the procedure, watch the format. What we are doing is not something that is so difficult. Just follow the rules and you get the whole thing done. Cost. You now think about any asset purchased in 2002. Then you put it up here and continue doing what you are doing. In 2002, we bought plants. Plants, 200,000 in 2002, and that's the only item purchased in 2002. So we're going to work on plant. So we have plant here, 200,000. You come under plant and put 200,000. That is the cost. Then you now put the IA. IA is the initial allowance for plants. All these places will have dash, dash, they will have dash here. That is the initial allowance of plants, which we have calculated. Now we have initial allowance to be 30,000 for plants. So we're going to insert the value and we have the annual allowance to be 51,000. So we have initial allowance 30,000. You bracket it and go to the A stream under capital allowance and put the same amount, 30,000. But remember, you don't have to bracket this. They will talk about annual allowance. Annual allowance is 51,000. 51,000. You have to bracket these two. Then you come here again and put 51,000. This one should not be bracketed. The bracket here shows that we're having a negative value. So this is the cost minus initial allowance minus the annual allowance. They will get the written down value. So this is how this 2002 goes. We clear this account. So what we're going to do now is to add up the capital allowance here, which will give us 81,000. We have 81,000. Then we have dash, dash. Then this is going to be 200,000 minus these two. Let's see what the calculator can do. We have 200,000 minus 30,000 minus 51,000. And that will give us 119,000. So 119,000. 119,000. So that becomes the written down value, WDV, at end of 2002. So we'll close up this account of 2002. And that is that. So the next thing we're going to do is we'll go to 2003. Remember that initial allowance is allowed only once throughout the useful life of an asset, but annual allowance is allowed every year until that asset is disposed or fully consumed. So that is how we handle the issue of initial and annual allowance. We are through with 2002. We shall be going to 2003. So we'll come here and put 2003. In 2003, we now talk about, you say, written down value brought forward, WDV brought forward. So you have to bring forward this figure, 119,000. So nothing is here, nothing is here, and nothing is here. We have computed the capital allowance in 2002. So the next thing is costs. Under cost, you are looking at any asset which was purchased in 2003, then it will come up. Already plant is here. We didn't purchase a new plant. If you purchased a new plant, it should come under plant again. And you compute initial allowance for that new plant purchased and annual allowance. Since we did not purchase any new plant, we're going to put dash here. Then look at any asset purchased. Let's check whether motor vehicle was purchased. Then we'll put it up here. Let's look at the next asset which was purchased. In 2003, motor vehicle was purchased in 2003, 450,000. So we're going to put it up right away. So we have motor vehicle here, 450,000. So nothing is here and nothing is here. Then we'll talk about initial allowance. Only this motor vehicle will have initial allowance because that's the new asset purchased. Then both of them will go with annual allowance because annual allowance is a continuous allowance until the asset is fully consumed or disposed. So we'll talk about initial allowance. Still in 2003, initial allowance, nothing will go for motor vehicle. So let's check the initial allowance for the next item. Nothing will go for plants. This is for plants. So let's check the initial allowance for motor vehicle from the analysis. Motor vehicle is here now. They will have an initial allowance with 45,000. Then the annual allowance is 6,750. So under this place, we have 45,000. Then you bracket it as usual. You put dash and then you still have it 45,000 here under capital allowance, just like what we did before. You talk about annual allowance. Annual allowance, you can abbreviate. Annual allowance will go for both of them because annual allowance is charged every year. So let's look at annual allowance for plant, the first item. Annual allowance for plant is 51,000. So we have 51,000 here. You bracket it, showing a negative. The annual allowance for motor vehicle. Motor vehicle annual allowance is 6,750. 7, 5, and then 0. We'll still bracket. So we're going to add these two and bring it here. So we'll be having a 51,000 plus 60,750. And that will give us 111,750. 111,750 and then 0. So we'll now go to, we'll balance up the account. We want to get the written down value at end of 2003. So what we're going to do now is to subtract 51,000 from what we have here under plants. Under plants, we have the written down value 119,000 minus 51,000. 119,000 minus 51,000. That will give 68,000. So we have 68,000 here. Then we're going to subtract these two from the cost of motor vehicles. The cost of motor vehicle is 450,000. 450,000. So we shall be having 450,000. 450,000 minus 45,000. 45,000 minus 67,500. 67,500 and then 0. That will give us 344,250. 344,250 and then 0. 344,250. That is our written down value. So nothing goes here. And then the value of total value of capital allowance should be 45,000 plus 111,750. So let's do that. 45,000 plus 111,750 and then 0. We have a total of 156,750. 156,750 and 0. That's the total capital allowance in the second year. We overrule. So we are through with 2003. We go to 2004. 2004. We have written down value brought forward. Written down value brought forward. So all these figures will come down, excluding this capital allowance. We have 68,000. We have 344,250. Then nothing goes here and nothing goes here. Then we'll talk about cost. Any new asset purchased in 2004 will come up here. So let's check. Equipment was purchased in 2004. I remember that we are told that the plant was sold in 2004 too. So we have to be very careful in our calculations. Let's carry out the issue of equipment which was purchased in 2004 first before we come to disposal at 300,000. So we have equipment, nothing here, nothing here. We have 300,000 for equipment. 300,000 and then 0. 300,000. So nothing here. Talk about initial allowance, IA. Initial allowance is only for the new equipment purchased. So nothing for this, nothing for this, because initial allowance is allowed only once. So we have initial allowance of equipment. Equipment is here now. Initial allowance is 60,000. And so we have 60,000 here. We bracket it and still put it here. 60,000. 6,000 and then 0. We'll talk about annual allowance. Annual allowance goes all through. Already we have annual allowance for the first one, 51,000. And then for the second one, 67,500. 67,500. Then the third one, which is equipment. Annual allowance for equipment here is 60,000. The initial allowance is not, shouldn't be 60,000. Let's check very well. How can this be? How can this? Initial allowance is 30,000 times 20%, which is 60,000. Then 30,000 again, 300,000. Minus 60,000, which is initial allowance, times 25%, still give us 60,000. So this minus this will give us 240,000 times 0.25. It's not supposed to give us 60,000. Let's check. 240,000 multiplied by 240,000 multiplied by 0.25. That will give 60,000. Okay. Since that is so, let's continue. So having the same value for initial allowance and annual allowance. That is what it means. So we have 60,000 again. still bracket, bracket all. You bracket all these because they are negatives. Then we're going to sum up these three and put it up under capital allowance. Then we'll have our calculator, 51,000 plus 750 plus 60,000. That will give us 171,750. 171,750. 171,750. So this is what we have here. Then we'll get our written down value at the end of 2004 before we now dispose. We have to sell the plant which was sold. As a written down value at the end, WDV at end of 2004. So we'll be having 68,000 minus 51,000. 68,000 minus 51,000, which is equal to 17,000. So we'll have 17,000 here. Then we'll do this. The second one is 344,250 minus 60,750. We have 283,500. 283,500. Then finally we have 300,000 minus 60,000 minus another 60,000. That will give us 180,000. We have 180,000. Then nothing goes here. Okay, we have to total this. That will be the total capital allowance in 2004. We have 60,000 plus 171,750. 231,750. 231,750. That's the total capital allowance in 2004. Now the next thing we're going to do now is to, before we conclude this 2004, we have to sell the plant which was sold. If you look at the question, they were told that the plant was sold in 2004, and the rest of capital allowance were as follows. Now the sale amount was not given to us. The sale amount was not given to us. That's the amount they sold it. Was not given to us. So if let's assume a figure now so that we can standardize the question, I'll be able to handle the issue of balancing charge and balancing allowance. So let's assume that the plant was sold for, let's say, 15,000. The plant was sold for 15,000. Sold for 15,000. I'm just putting this so that you can understand what we are talking about under balancing charge and balancing allowance, since it's not given here. It's supposed to be provided in this question. So now we'll now talk about this before we conclude that account. So having sale of plant of 15,000 in 2004. So now the written down value is 17,000 for plant. We'll talk about disposal. Come here, right? We are still on in 2004. You say disposal, that is for sales. Disposal 15,000. 15,000. Now, since it's going to be a positive value, then the written down value is going to be a negative value. This 17,000 is going to be a negative value. We have to bracket it now because we are disposing it. We are selling it off. So you bracket this, then remove this 17,000 from 15,000 to check whether we made a profit or we made a loss. That will give us minus 2,000. So put 2,000 here and close it. So this 2,000 is what we call balancing allowance. Balancing allowance. So if you sell at profit, it is called a balancing charge. But if you sell at loss, it's a balancing allowance. Because now the written down value is greater than the disposal amount or the sale amount. That's why having a balancing charge, this is a loss, it's a negative. So that closes the account. Then what it means is that this plant can no longer reflect in this account because we have disposed it. Then we'll have to close up the account finally. So we have the net written down value, net WDV at end of that year because we consider the issue of disposal. So nothing is going to be here. So we are through with this because it has been disposed. We have to bring down the values here and that's all. Then we'll close up the account and go to the next year. So here we're having 283,500. 283,500. and this place is 180,000. 283500. Then we have 180,000 here. Our total capital allowance will still be here, which is 231750. We have 231 75 and then zero. So that is the end of this 2004. Finally, we're going to the last year, which is 2005. So we have 2005. We say written down value brought forward. So all these figures will come down. Nothing goes here, we have zero. Then this one is 283500. This is 180,000. Nothing here. Then we'll talk about cost. Any new asset purchased? I don't think there's any other asset purchased. Let's check the question. In 2005. So in the question here, there's no new asset that was purchased because the last purchase made here is was 300,000 in 2004. So costs. No cost. We have dash, 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 and dash. Then we'll talk about initial allowance. Since there is no cost, there will be no initial allowance. So have dash, 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 and dash. They will talk about annual allowance. So all the annual allowance will be brought down here and the account will be closed up. For plant, we're going to have dash because plant was disposed. Nothing concerns plant again with this question. They will go to the second item, which is motor vehicles. Annual allowance for motor vehicle is 6750. 6075 and then zero. You have to bracket this man. Then for plant, the last one. For equipment, the last one is equipment, which is 60,000. We have it here, 60,000. So we have 60,000 here. Then we'll add this to be getting 120,750. 120,750 and then zero. So that is all about capital allowance. Then we'll now get the final value, the written down value at the end. We have the written down value WDV at end of 2005. So we're going to do 283500 minus 6750. 283500 minus 60750. And that will give us 222750. 222750 and then zero. The 180,000 minus 160,000 is going to give us 120,000. So we have 120,000 here. Then the total capital allowance for 2005 will be 120,750. 120,750. So at this point, we have to close up the account. And that will bring us to the end of the question. To close up this account. So that is the written down value at the end of 2005. That will bring us to the end of this question. This is just illustration one. So what you should do is to insert this three for you to look at illustration two, which is going to be more technical and more difficult than this. So that is just that. This is how you carry out your analysis under capital allowance.